Hello and welcome. Silrace here with Surviving the Aftermath. So I've been looking a little bit here before I began recording again. And one of those things I was looking at is the fact that there seems to be a sort of a time limit to getting yourself to wherever the places they are. This thing. Because at some point you are going to run out of the overland deposits. At some point those are simply going to run out. And that is going to be a problem. Oh, right, there's a dead colonist. Somebody's still working on that to get the colonist back from that sandworm death. I'm going to move these closer to the settlement now, so that nobody else dies to that stuff. That would be beneficial. We need to get rid of that damn thing. Well, there is a concrete ruin there, but I don't know if I dare to send somebody there before this is scouted. So those can hang around. There is a small concrete ruin there. Right now I have more planks than concrete anyway, so. Alright. Overall, I would say that takes a little bit of doing. In the sense that it is a time limited thing, which I need to work on a whole lot. I need a lot of research to get there. I am pretty close right now to finally getting to protected crops. And then we can basically have greenhouses to do the rest of our food production after that. So if I wanted to, I could close this fishing pier and everything else. Of all that sort of thing. I should build another water well at some point soon. And the other thing is that science is obviously a little bit of a problem. I could demolish one of these and move them over here. It can wait. So really because the big problem with the science right now is that if I really want to get a whole lot of science, I need outposts for places like this, which generate 10 per day. And I can't really currently afford to spend my specialists on that. Alright. Oh, let's see. Bandits have been defeated. 3 days to get the iodine pills. Then get you moving towards home. Yeah, sure. You got the science from there, go get the science from there. You have blown up some bandits. This takes 3 days. Alright, fine. Do that as well. How tough are these bandits? 12 damage per bandit. That is a lot of damage, man. Same thing here. Alright, fine. And you were going for the... Alright, antibiotics. Sure. Alright. We need the medicine. We have, like, none. Alright, let this run again. Colonist under attack. What? Oh, you have got to be kidding me. And the colonist doesn't understand to run the fluff away. Of course doesn't. Yep. Gonna be another dead colonist. Oh, just get away. Oh, got away. So we got the dead body out of there without the colonist dying. Alright, that is perfect. Remember, that's a double sandworm there, so we need like all four of these people. Well, all four of them are damaged, so we're gonna bring them home pretty soon. And then we can go deal with some of this annoyance. Deal with some of that craziness. We still have. Yeah, we're still treating a whole lot of people. Whole lot of people are still getting treated. And we have our guard posts are up. Okay, good. Could consider demolishing one of these and moving it over here. Not necessarily be a horrible idea. Just put it right here. Once we get the next set of science from Kate, we actually get our protected crops finally. Start to get that unlocked, and after that, I think the next step is really to start working on getting to here. It's gonna be a lot of tech, but getting there is gonna be the big thing. Because I have wind turbines, I have electricity I can do, but I do need these things dug out to get access to all of this craziness. That is going to be real nice. There is so much plastic. Yeah. Right. Oh, where is my? Out of curiosity, where are you picking your metal right now? Oh, from there. I can move it over there actually and pick that metal. Yeah, let's do that. Actually, let's do that. I mean, if we clear out all of this, we can just put industrial stuff on top of it, and suddenly we have an influx of this stuff. All of this seems to be working right now. But my wells are so well hidden that finding them is a different thing. How is there still zero dead over there? Did the sandworms eat it? Or did the poison just not bring it because they went to the medical tent? That is a possibility as well. But if we don't need you folks here, we don't need you here, and I can put you to other jobs. Which is to say, yeah, firewood, we need planks. Yeah, you folks are chopping this down faster than the single forester is planting it, so we should send one of you to cut down other areas of the map again, I think. Yeah, like all these trees from here. Let's get all those trees, I suppose. I'm gonna send you those trees out of my way. Alright, specialists were ready, I think. Ready for action, you. We need those. Everybody else is still doing their stuff. No, not you though, you're doing that now. Okay, very good. Everybody is doing something. Now let's speed this up. Speed the day up. Gonna put somebody to sit in there just in case. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Yeah, we are constantly. Okay. This is a good or bad thing. Let's put another person here. Another person in the gate, just in case. We're no specialist, but we get 6 more people. Ooh, we get parts. Oh, that is really nice. 3 colonists are homeless, which is not a problem. We just build some tents. Let's double check this area. I should cut down this tree. These trees here. Alright. know what? I will build two tents straight away. Yeah, this is a weird little piece of road I have built here. Eh, that's fine. That is fine. Look at the amount of our food keeps jumping. Even though we are supposed to be consuming more than we produce, we are still producing so much. Holy moly, man. Well, then again, we did just get some candy bars and whatnot. Speaking of which, what do you folks have for trade? I could buy more parts. Definitely gonna need more parts. I could be buying sheep. I don't have anywhere I can store sheep right now. I don't really want wheat just yet. Wheat seed. I could be buying some parts though. Let's wait a sec and see. If I just sell fun boxes, I could probably just sell, you know, candy bars away. Where was the other thing? Things like this I could just sell away. This point. Could sell you some cockroaches. You interested in cockroaches? How about I also sell some junk again? Since I am not turning the junk into things. Okay, that's 137. That almost pays for 15 of these. Let's say I spend a little money and buy 20. Alright. Sell things I definitely don't need, like candy bars and stuff. Those can go. And get some parts, so that I can build more stuff. I need to bring the components from the world map as well. And finally, I think I have start to have like... Ooh, protected crops is being done. Fantastic. I was just about to say, I think I may start how to have... Oh, nice. Cut these trees? Or... You know what? Let's specifically cut that tree right now. Alright. So... Now I could do things like get remembrance and education next. I do have enough people now to start like really doing this. Remembrance, education. I do not want to go to shanties and tenements until I have the underground metal extraction. Because these things are gonna eat so much of my metal. So I have no real rush to get there. No real requires access to water tower. Maybe we don't want that upgrade just yet. Yeah, we might go memorial after this, just to get a happiness boost in here, and maybe do education, and then beeline straight into the. Oh, somebody died of old age. Do we still have? Yeah, we still have somebody working here. Alright, now I'm finally getting dead colonists. Slowly but surely. Alright. So we have a couple of houses again. Decontaminate that, will you? Thanks. Eventually I wanna be able to start removing this pollution. Oh, there we go! Harvest crops before they wither. Okay, I do have medic tents and stuff, so that is not exactly a problem. Do we harvest this stuff, like, right now? Yes, we do. Kick you out of here. Don't need to plant anything. Move this work area. We got the tree from there, so we can now... Like plant there and stuff, get those trees next. Trying to make space here. I can just as well at this point throw people here. It's not like we need carriers that much at the moment. Is this a point where I build another fishing pier just to for during this nuclear fallout? Oh yeah, speaking of, let's not worry about that, let's worry about these damn water wells. I need two of them for this nuclear fallout, don't I? I'm not gonna... Oh yeah, there is a plus 10 right here. Plus 10 water well right there, and can we find a... Well, there is a 9 right here. Can we get a plus 10 somewhere here? Nope. Oh, we can. Perfect. Okay, give me those two. Do I build another clean water storage? Possibly. Oh right, this is the one thing I wanted to check. I cannot... I can fit another tent here. Is that in range? It is barely in range here. I have to keep that in mind. I can fit another tent in there as well. I may want another water tower though, like somewhere here, so that there is enough. I'm just gonna eat most of my metal right now, but I do want more water for to try and have even more water for these buildings. That's the thing I'm going for here. I'll kill the road for it. I'm gonna need water towers for these things anyway. Might do it like right here and then build. I have no idea how big greenhouses are. So we'll build it there. Alright. Okay, specialists. Okay, you have. What do you have? Iodine bells. Return you to colony. This is gonna take a few days, but that's fine. You have ports. Do I bring you back to colony as well now? I should get this metal. Because we are getting low on metal. Fine. Let's do that because you're not carrying iodine pills, so that's fine. Okay, you got the science covered. Let's scout this. And then bring you home. We need to clear those sandworms. Oh, that is a good reminder, actually. That I really should not do this, and I just send you home. Because as soon as you are done, I'm gonna send you home as well, so we can go with four people, we can go clear those sandworms. Okay, all of you have harvested stuff, so I'm gonna kick you folks out of here. Hopefully to get these things built nice and the couple of wells built up before this nuclear fallout hits. We are doing protected crops right now. Alright, very good. I think I have to research for bloody heck, what is that? Oh, you know what? At this point we can probably put an end to this thing. And an end to the clothing clothing and whatnot thing. What do you want? Oh, sure. Oh, yeah. Definitely. Huh. 3 fiber for 5 clothing. Alright. Yeah, now we have a few carriers running around. Charging productive crops. Folks, huh? Building my wells? Yes, you are. You're building my wells. That's good. I am not finding it very difficult. Manage food and water so far. Okay, now we have a good amount of water in income, so. There it is, -6. Because this thing is not working. And that means we need another water well somewhere. I need a 6-point water well. Right there. There is one over here already. Alright, I can find a 10 right there. Okay. Go over there and build that. It is a little bit of a shame to do not have an extra potion I could put into those. Oh, this is, this would be nice, a harvesting speed for this stuff, but that can definitely wait. I am going to spend my next into remembrance and education. It's 250. I have the science for that actually right now. So yeah, definitely doing that. Okay, well, after I get this this well up, I won't need this thing running for a while either. It's just gonna be a nice backup for when I need it. Alright, you. Okay, I'm gonna give you these trees. Get rid of those for me. Yeah, sure. I could build another forester here. I think that might be what we try and build. Let's put a pause here for a sec. I think that is what we do build here. What? Let's just put it right there. Put the other forester here as well, so they can keep planting there. Alright, this water collector doesn't work either right now. Alright, 14 colonies irradiated. Do I need even more of these damn things? As in medical tents? I could build more here. My metal is a little low. Fine, let's build a third one. 22 colonies irradiated, oh yeah. There we go. Hey, berries got depleted, don't really care about that. Yeah, not having any medicine is a little awful. Really, really, really need those medicine men. Okay, you can return to colony. You can return to colony. Let's make sure everybody is on their way back. Yeah, everybody is on their way back. This is probably over by the time we get the iodine pearls back, but oh well. If we get lucky, we don't lose anybody to those things, so. Alright. Perfect. Now we have... Wait, that went by real fast. What? Okay, that went by real fast. Damn. Well, we still have some people who need to be healed. But damn, that went by fast. Okay, let's start decontaminating this stuff here. I should probably see eventually remove all the outhouses and build something else. This thing, decontaminate that as well. I know you can build buildings which do that for you, for somebody to do automated stuff on it. But frankly, it can't be bothered to. I'll do some of this stuff manually and call it a day. Okay, we have another forester. Work area right here, thank you. Alright, I'm about to have protected crops. That is going to be real nice. Trade convoy. Nice. We have so much parts now. Not sure we have enough components to do this. Okay, protected crops. Let's, start with the remembrance and then consider education as afterwards. Probably a good idea, finally. Now, greenhouses. Oh, only 5 components. Okay, that is not awful. Oh, these are fairly dang small, actually. Hey. So they need to be in the area of that water tower, which means we can plonk them around it like here, and put another one on the other side, and then even one more like here. Oh yeah, can definitely fit one right there. Leave a little space around. Run a road. This. Alright. We can demolish these things out of the way. What? What happened? I heard some kind of a crazy noise. Decontaminate that. Oh right, yeah, one of these things probably just blew up again and irradiated stuff. That's fine. Now, I need wind turbines to keep these greenhouses going. So let's figure that out, shall we? 8 metal, damn! I'm not able to make a lot of this. And those are actually larger than I thought they would be. Well, that's not really a problem. How much did these things cost? 2 electricity only. Alright, fine. I can do 1 wind turbine. Somewhere right here. Okay. Then run the road around it. Like that. And then I needed a battery rack. And a... No, a transformer. Oh, that means... oh, bloody heck. Fine. Transformer is gonna be there. Okay. And we might want a battery rack somewhere nearby as well. To keep the batteries running. Oh, somebody died of radiation sickness. Well then. Now we're slowly and surely losing people. Even though we have 3 medical tents working fully. Well, I mean, if we only lost one person from that entire nuclear fallout, then everything is just dandy still. Everything is just fine still. If only one person died to that craziness. Now, where do I put my remembrance? Maybe somewhere here. We have transformer up. Yeah, we just barely. Another one died. Alright, now we are really losing people, huh? Yeah, three people dead. While we are treating, huh? Okay, fine. You are here, doesn't... Yeah, we got the Ardyne pills now. Two colonists died of radiation, oh well. Okay, that's plastic gone. Where do we find more plastic? Over there. Alright. Anywhere safer? Nope. So you can stay there for the moment. Oh, is that decontaminated? What? What in the what? Anyway! Man, decontaminate that too. Damn! So I'm gonna call it an episode right here. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you folks next time with more Surviving the Aftermath.